Hi. So my friend Shreya Vyas has told me to take one topic that what is to be studied in for NEET entrance regarding the biochemistry. So actually regarding biochemistry, NEET entrance your questions are very difficult, and as such biochemistry is so volatile. But the main mistake that students are doing is they are reading only metabolism. This is a very general topic. I will tell which topics you have to focus on. Students generally focus on metabolism and cycles, but the thing is that no one is asking that. No one will ask you direct question from the cycle. And though metabolism will not be the only question that you will get in biochemistry, just studying the cycles, you forget to do the rest of the questions and you lose on marks. See, the most important and the most easiest is classification. Do the classification of everything, all carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, amino acids. Classification should be nicely done, especially the essential amino acids. Know them well, and at least one question, if you are lucky, at least one question comes from classification, general chemistry, because general chemistry has to be a part of the question. The second important question comes from practical. See, if it's a well-balanced paper, all the topics will be taken into account. So in practicals, you've done color reaction of proteins when you were in UG, undergraduate first year. So at least know which color gives which. And they ask Benedict's test or any other test, for example, Rothera's test and the Vacutainers. Sometimes they do ask, sometimes they do not ask because you have already completed your internship. So you should know in red Vacutainer which blood is taken for which investigation, and gray Vacutainer you will take which blood for which investigation. So this is also mostly forgotten, but it is easy to score in this. The next point comes the nutrition. So in nutrition, generally we all know protein, energy, malnutrition. That topic we all cover nicely. What we do not cover nicely is vitamins and minerals. Actually, it is very difficult to remember all the vitamins and minerals, very difficult for me also. Just read the important points for which mineral deficiency or which vitamin deficiency, what happens. Actually, for which mineral deficiency, which is the disease, that will be good. And in vitamins, which vitamin is used in which cycle. So that is more important, especially it is done for vitamin B, that it was used in these reactions. So you should know which vitamin is used in which reaction. Coming to the instrumentation, that is also a weak point of most of the students. Instrumentation may mostly focus on electrophoresis and chromatography. But the other recent technology is mass spectrometry. I don't know how much does one would like you to know about mass spectrometry. But since you get questions from newborn errors of metabolism, so mass spectrometry is the investigation for newborn errors of metabolism mostly. It is diagnosed only on the basis of this instrument, nothing else. So you should know mass spectral, at least a little bit of it, and newborn errors. In newborn errors also, we have this list, PIDPAD, autosomal dominant and autosomal recessive. You should know which is autosomal dominant, which is autosomal recessive, and you should know which enzyme deficiency will lead to which disorder. That is why how cycles are connected to newborn errors. If you see, cycles are connected to newborn errors, cycles are connected to vitamins, and cycles are connected to your genetics also, some or the other way. So the other topic that actually we do not consider in biochemistry, because we consider it in PSM, preventive social medicine, is biostats. Biostats comes in biochemistry because biochemistry is a research oriented topic, research oriented subject. So we need to know mean, median, mode, standard deviation, which population, what is the normal difference range, how do we calculate the normal differences. So generally it is taken into PSM, but it can come, it is a very small topic in biochemistry. The other major topic is genetics, and in genetics we read everything, but we do not actually read mRNA, rRNA, tRNA and the other small types of RNA, microRNA, hnRNA and chaperones. So you should know all these terms, all these things, and at least do replication, transcription and translation well. From here I do not mean the theory point of view, but I mean the cycles. You should know which factor, how, when, what is coming, how, which ribosome is helping, what are the ribosomes taking part into it. You should know all that. So in a very nutshell, the topics that you have to cover for your NEET PG entrance. I know it is on 5th of January and it is very difficult to tell you now that you have to do this topics, but the main motto of this was, do not just concentrate on metabolism, please do not forget your instrumentation or do not forget your general chemistry. For one question to be correct, do not forget all the other 9 questions that you have to do. Okay, so concentrate, focus, and biochemistry is difficult for everybody, so do not take stress about it, but it's a tiebreaker subject. I've always told to all my students, it's a tiebreaker subject. It is the only subject that takes you a few notches higher to the rest of the students. So that's all. Thank you.